Assalamu alaikum, dear students. I hope you all will be fine and doing great. I welcome you all to English Revision online class. In today's class, we will do the revision of book exercises. We will revise the book exercises of unit number 16, which is Ali Baba and the 40 Thieves. It's unit number 16. First, we will do the revision of exercise B, which is on page number 82. So this is the exercise B and it's on page number 82. So there are some sentences given below on the base of the information that is given to us, that is provided to us in the unit. So Ali Baba. Ali Baba was a poor fishmonger. False. No, he was a poor woodcutter. Ali Baba saw the 40 thieves in the forest. Yes, it's true. He saw 40 thieves in the forest. Then Ali Baba knew the magic words. Yes, he knew the magic words. Ali Baba killed the thieves. False. No, he did not kill the thieves. The servant girl Marjana killed the thieves. Now Qasim. Qasim was the father of Ali Baba. False. No, he was not the father of Ali Baba. Yes, he was in relation with Ali Baba. And his relation was that he was the brother of Ali Baba. So the answer is false. Qasim followed Ali Baba to the cave. Yes, he followed Ali Baba to the cave because he saw Ali Baba coming in and out of the cave and he also wanted to get some treasure for himself too. So for that purpose, for that reason, he followed Ali Baba to the cave. So the answer is true. Qasim was killed by the thieves. Yes, sadly, he was killed by the thieves because he forgot the magic words and he was left behind inside the cave and suddenly, unexpectedly, the thieves came and they killed him. And in this way, he was killed by the thieves. Qasim forgot the words to leave the cave. Yes, he forgot to the words to leave the cave. And he was left behind inside the cave. And then he was later on killed by the thieves. Marjana. Marjana was Ali Baba's wife. No, she was Ali Baba's servant. Marjana was very clever. Yes, she was very clever. Marjana killed all the thieves. Yes, she killed all the thieves. And Marjana poured hot water into the jars. Yes, she poured something into the jars to kill the thieves, but she did not pour hot water. She poured hot boiling oil into the jars. And in this way, all the thieves were killed. Now, exercises on page number 83. Exercise A on page number 3 is about vowels. So, what are vowels? Vowels, there are total 5 vowels. A, E, I, O, U. How many vowels there are? 5 vowels. A, E, I, O, U. And if the word begins with A, E, I, O, U, we have to put AND with it. We have to use AND with it. And if the word doesn't begin with A, E, I, O, U, then that word is known as consonant and we have to put A with it, okay? And if the word doesn't start with A, E, I, O, U, but it sounds like A, E, I, O, U, if the first letter of the word sounds like A, E, I, O, U, then we are also supposed to put AN with it, okay? So exercise A is all about using vowels, using A or AN. So there are 8 sentences. My uncle is an illustrator who draws a picture, who draws pictures in books. So illustrator is the word and it begins with I. So we have to put an with it. My mom has a quiet office in the house where she can work. Quiet is a word. It doesn't start with A-E-I-O-U and it doesn't sound like A-E-I-O-U. So it's a consonant. So we have to put A with it. She is afraid of heights and had an awful time at the fun fair. Awful is the word and it's beginning with A. So we have to put an with it. We have a lovely apple tree in our back garden. Lovely is the word, so we have to put A with it. Do you have an envelope for this letter, please? Envelope is the word, so we have to put an with it. It's a vowel, it's starting with E. My brother lives in an apartment in Karachi city. Apartment is the word, so we have to put an with it. Because it's a vowel, it's starting with A. We have a dash scarecrow in the field to frighten the crows. Scarecrow is the word. It doesn't sound like a vowel and it doesn't start with a vowel. So we have to put A with it. An excited little girl came over to show me her loose tooth. Which excited girl? An excited girl. Why? Because excited is the word. It's beginning with E. It's a vowel. So we have to put A with it. Now here, note down very important point that here I have written A in capital letter. Why? Because it's the beginning of a sentence. And whenever there's a beginning of a sentence, we use the first letter in capital form. So don't forget this point. Now moving towards the genders. So basically genders are categorized into 2 main categories, masculine and the feminine. So in exercise B is all about masculine and feminine genders. They have given us some nouns and there are some 16 nouns. these are some feminines and we have to write the masculine of the given feminines. Like for example, woman, man, girl, boy, mother, father, sister, brother, aunt, uncle, lady, lord or gentleman, madam, sir, queen, king, daughter, son, niece, nephew. Now what is niece? Niece is the daughter of your brother or sister and it's the opposite gender, and the masculine is nephew, princess, prince, grandfather, grandmother, grandfather, wife, husband, landlord, landlady. What is landlord? Landlord is the person who owns a piece of a land or a property, is known as landlord. And the opposite gender, the feminine of landlady, the masculine of landlady is landlord. Duchess, duke. Now what is duchess and duke? If a person holds or have an authority or position in hereditary, something they have in bond, that is known as duchess and duke. Widow and widower. Widow is a woman whose husband has died and he has not married again, so she is termed as widow. And the opposite gender, the masculine, is widower. Now moving toward exercise C, now they have given us some masculines and we have to write the feminine of the given masculines. Loin, loinus, fox, vixen, drake, duck, bull, cow, peacock, peahen, cold, filly, cold, young horse, a baby horse is known as cold, and the feminine young baby horse is known as filly. Dog, bitch, ram, ewe, ram is a sheep, okay. Stallion, mare, stallion is a masculine of an adult grown-up horse, and the feminine of adult grown-up horse is mare. Now moving towards the exercises on page number 85. So in this exercise, they have given us a word and they have made two sentences of the given word, and we have to read both of the sentences and we have to put a tick mark in front of a sentence in which the given word is used in a correct way, in a correct form. Okay, for example, modern, the new bathroom looked very modern. We stayed still when we saw the modern. So in sentence number one, the word modern is used correctly, so we have to put a tick mark on it. Senses, he senses most of the time, we fill in the senses form together. So in the second sentence, the word senses is used correctly. So we have to put a tick mark in front of a second sentence. What is census? Census means survey. For example, if you want to know the population of a Peshawar, so for that you need to do a survey. So that is known as, and to do a survey you need a certain form, and that form is known as census. Customer, it is important to listen to the customer. Yes, it's a sentence, it's the word in this sentence, the customer is used correctly. Plentiful means enough. The glass overflowed when it was plentiful. The food was plentiful at the party. Chemical, her hair dye is a chemical used to hair color. My favorite subject in school is chemical. First of all, chemical is not a subject, chemistry is a subject. So in sentence number one, the word chemical is used correctly. So we have to put a tick mark in front of it. Exercise C is all about syllable. So they have given us some words, some letters, and we have to make a second syllable. We have to add other words to make a second syllable to make a word. So every one of you have written your own answers. I'm also sharing my answers so you can tally it. Okay, so exercise E is all about teaser time. They have given us some words and we have to remove one letter. We have to remove one letter from anywhere where we want to make a new word. Bail, lab, screen, cream, style, tile, aisle, draw, crew, us, eat. Now moving toward the exercises on page number 86. So in the above block, they have given us some words, and in the below block, they have also given us words. So we have to write the word in front of each word that matches the description of the given word. Okay, so there are two words having the similar meanings. Like what is pair of words? Pair of words like having two words having similar pronunciation, same pronunciation, but the meanings are different, the spellings are different. Here, the spellings are also different. The pronunciation is different, but the meaning is same. The description is same. okay? Like, for example, often, frequently. Whenever, for example, when you do something very oftenly, very frequently, so that is known as frequently. Step by step, methodically. When you do something step by step, you follow all the steps, so that is known as methodically. Again and again, when you do something again and again, so that is known as repeatedly. Late, when you're late for something, for example, if your friend is having a birthday and you forgot to wish her, and then you wish her birthday after 2 or 3 days, then you'll say that happy belated birthday. So it means that you're late to wish her birthday. Almost by accident, incidentally, once each year, if something that happens once in a year, once in each year, so that is known as annually. Now and then, occasionally, for a short period, temporarily, all the time, constantly, with particular intent, with particular point, that is known as pointedly. Okay, so here in the above block they have given us some words, and in the below block they have given us some description, and we have to match the description with the words, and it's this exercise is based on the information given to us in the unit. Ali Baba was poor woodcutter. He knew the magic words, and those magic words were open sesame, closed sesame. Ali Baba found gold and jewels. Marjiana was clever servant or servant. She was very clever. 40 jar contains thieves and oil. Okay, in exercise C, they have given us some noun, and we have to state that whether the given noun is feminine or masculine, and we have to write F or M in front of it. Madam, it's a feminine, so we have to put F with it. Fox, it's a masculine. PN is a feminine. Husband is a masculine. Daughter is a feminine. Mayor is a feminine. Prince is a masculine. You is a feminine. Niece is a feminine. And King is a masculine. So dear girls, dear students, this was all about the revision of the exercise of unit number 6, Ali Baba and the 40 Thieves. I hope that you understood it and there would be no problem in difficulty. Now I'm assigning you a homework, and your homework is that you have to learn pair of words which you have done in your English notebook on your B side. Okay, so you have to learn pair of words, and inshallah in the next online class I'm going to take the test of it. Thank you very much.